Hi friends, today we're going to be working on a drawing of Peter Rabbit, an illustration for the story, and I'm excited to get started. So today we are listening to the story of Peter Rabbit, and I'm going to be drawing a rabbit on this piece of paper. This is just the inside of my Stouffer's lasagna box that I cut up. I like to reuse things like that. And I'm going to be looking at this drawing that I've done previously and making it bigger and simplifying it and then adding his details. So I'm going to start by looking for my shapes. The first shape I see in that face is kind of a teardrop shape, and I'm doing it really loose and light, and I want it really dark because if I mess up, I want to be able to erase it. And the next shape I see is kind of an oval shape. Then I see these upside down U's here, and it looks like the legs cross in the front and they're sort of long and skinny. Come back this way, because it looks like he is running, so he could be running away from Farmer McGregor. I'm gonna be putting another oval here, and then I'm just gonna clean it up a little bit. I wanna make sure that I like the way that it looks, that everything's crossing right. And then I've got his little face. I'm gonna do another almond shape here for the eye. And his nose and his mouth are really close together. You'll barely kind of see them. They're not like cat or dog face. They are really close to the bottom. Okay, so now I want to kind of Peter him up. So right now he looks like a rabbit, but he doesn't look like Peter Rabbit. So I'm going to add his little collar. And he was wearing like a jacket, so maybe I'll make his jacket like flying off. Maybe I should have waited to darken this up because I'm going to take this back out, but it looks like it's coming out. Maybe I'll give him a couple of coattails, like he's wearing an old-fashioned coat. And I want to make it, I know they mentioned buttons, so maybe I'll show those buttons here. And then I want him to look kind of worried. So if his eyebrows go down, he's going to look angry. If they're a little up and away, he's going to look a little bit worried. He's nervous. Maybe he's going to have some sweat flying off, like he's really nervous. And I'm going to put the ground kind of underneath in a way, like he's really running. He's running so fast that he's left the ground. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Sharpie and I'm going to go over all of that. Give him some wind marks, like, 'cause it looks like he's really running fast because he wants to get away from Farmer McGregor. Maybe open his eyes up a little bit. Good. And then what I'm going to do after that is just add some watercolor. Okay, so now I'm going to add my watercolor. If you don't have watercolor at home, that's totally fine. You could use crayon to do this. And I remember from the story that they said his coat was blue. So that's why I'm going to be using blue for his coat. I like to think about those details in the story when I'm illustrating something so that people kind of know what story it is. It doesn't need to look just like Beatrix Potter's pictures, but it should remind us of the story in some special way. So I'm going to add those colors. And when I'm using watercolor, I like to switch back and forth, even if it's a color that it maybe wouldn't be in real life. It has mostly blue, but I'll throw a little purple in there for interest, and then I'll blue up this collar. Now, because I've used blue in the jacket, I probably don't want to do that in my background. So that offers a challenge, like what color can we put in the background that would be interesting to look at and not be blue? And you know that if there's a sunset, that the background can be any color that you want it to be. So I'm gonna put in a little bit this pinkish reddish color. And I got my background wet first. That's gonna help the color spread and join together beautifully. In a sunset, it's gonna switch colors. So I'm switching now to orange, which will look really nice to, next to my red because it's next to it in the rainbow. And because I've gotten my background wet, it's gonna blend together beautifully. Now I'm gonna switch to yellow and bring that yellow down here, and I'll probably do the whole rest of my background yellow. And I'm gonna go right around him because I don't wanna accidentally paint him yellow. I might even leave a little space around him so I don't accidentally get that color into his jacket, because that's gonna turn it green, because yellow and blue make green. So now I'm gonna go down here into my grass area and add my grass color. And I can switch greens a couple of times because I have more than one green in my palette. That just makes it a little bit more interesting to look at when you switch those colors around. And I can even mix a little bit of that yellow in to brighten it up. Okay, I'm going to wait for this to dry to add color to his body. But I'm going to do brown, and I can't wait to see what you do. I hope it's awesome. I hope you have a good time. Don't think that you have to use watercolor because I did. You can use any medium that you want to. I hope to see you again tomorrow.